Hey, New Hope, Pastor Brian here. I hope you're having a good day and a good weekend. I wanted to say happy Father's Day to all the dads out there. Pray that this weekend is really great for you and spending time with your family, relaxing. We're thankful for you, dads. We're thankful for your hard work, for your faith-filled lives. And I want to give a special challenge to all the dads out there, whether you've been a dad for several years or maybe you're going to be a first-time dad this coming year, to make this next year the strongest year of your life spiritually, to grow in your faith, to become so grounded and cemented in your faith like never before. But not only for that, but to lead others, to lead your family and those around you in their faith, to set an example for them to follow. So I challenge you in that, and let's make this next year really incredible for all the dads. I want to give you a quick word of encouragement today. Many of us grew up playing this game as a child called tag. So basically the concept is you just don't want to get tagged. You don't want to get touched by the person who is quote unquote it. And if you did, now all of a sudden you are it, and your objective is to go and touch the other person to make them the person that is it. And it's even grown into the point where there are actual adult leagues worldwide that play this game of tag. One of the leagues that I came across during my homebound time during all this virus is called the World Chase Tag. So adults playing this game, there is a complicated obstacle course that they're avoiding getting tagged. And one of the episodes that I saw during the time that I was watching was to get from point A to point B without getting touched. Seems simple, but the course that they had to go through was very complicated. And obviously, once you get to point B, if you haven't been tagged, you are in the safe zone. Whether you're touching that wall or you're past that line, you're safe. And even if you think about it, when kids play this, when I played it, sometimes there was like a decided upon area that was like the safe zone. So if someone was in that safe zone, they could not be tagged and could not be touched. And even when little kids play this, they get that sense of I'm about to get tagged. And instead of running to that safe zone, sometimes they would run to their parent that was standing close by. And even though that mom or dad was not playing the game, the kid would go to their parent and cling to the leg and, in a sense, say, I'm safe. You can't tag me. I'm with my dad or I'm with my mom. Proverbs 18:10 says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and are safe. So as believers, we are to turn to the Lord. We are to run to the Lord for refuge and strength. It says that his name is a strong tower. And his name represents who he is. It represents his character. It also represents his authority in all situations. So all throughout the Bible, there are several names, several descriptions that it gives us for God and for Jesus. And I encourage and I challenge all of us here that this summer, as you go through your personal time of reading, of devotions with the Lord, to begin to write down and jot down those names and those descriptions of God that you come across. And look up quickly what they represent about God, a biblical definition of it. And it's going to be something that will enrich your faith. It will cement your faith like never before. So quick, fun little challenge for you to do this summer. But I want to share with you three of those names. The first one, Emmanuel, God with us. This is beyond something that we sing about or talk about at Christmas time, though that's kind of the season of life that we think about it more because of Jesus coming to this earth to be God with us. But I want you to remember that God is faithfully with us. And even though Jesus ascended into heaven, he sent us his promised Holy Spirit to always be with us. Another name or description of God is Most High. He is higher than any kings or rulers of this earth. He is higher and greater than any false gods of any nation, of any person that may be alive or living here on this earth. He is the Most High. And finally, the Almighty. God is all-sufficient. He's in heaven, and he is adequate in every situation. He is undefeated, and he has invincible power. Two more Bible verses that I want to share with you before we pray. Psalm 18:2 says, "The Lord is my rock, my fortress, my deliverer. My God is my rock, in whom I take refuge. He is my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold." And then Psalm 91 verse 2 says, "I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust." So remember today that you can call on Emmanuel, the Most High, Almighty God, and he is with you. He hears you. Run to him for that refuge and that strength, the strong tower of his name. Run to him for that. It doesn't mean that the battle ends. It doesn't necessarily mean that the storm will end in the current situation that you are in, but it does mean that you will have the Almighty, Most High God defending you and protecting you. So let's pray. God, we thank you for today, and I pray that each of us would grow in our faith. I pray a special blessing upon all of the dads out there, that you would strengthen them, encourage them, challenge them, Lord, to grow in their faith this next year. I pray that each and every one of us, as believers in you, that we would run to you for the safety, the strength, the refuge, the peace that we need in so many times of our life, that you and your name would really be that strong tower that we need. And we're so thankful for that. God, help us today. Bless your people. In your mighty name we pray. Amen. Have a great Saturday, New Hope. Look forward to seeing you all tomorrow. Again, happy Father's Day, dads. See you later.